Hello everyone, today I'm going to show you how to make a leaderboard using the StarCraft II editor. So first what you want to do is open up the editor, which I have already done, and I have made a default units and made them allies. You can do whatever you want for your map, but first what you want to do is make a new trigger. I'm going to name it leaderboard. And then what you want to make the event is the default. So now what you want to do under the actions is you want to create a leaderboard. So mine is going to have two columns and four rows because I'm going to have four players. And you want to make your rows however many players you have. And I'm going to name it simply leaderboard. Okay, so now what you want to do is on the side here, you want to make a new variable. I'm going to name it leaderboard again and make it a leaderboard type. And then go back to that other trigger that you just made and make a new action, set variable, and set that variable that you just made to equal the last created leaderboard. Okay, so that's the first part. Now what you want to do is add the players. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pick each integer, because for some reason when you pick each player it has some problems when you have them before other actions. So I'm just going to do integer, it'll work just as well. So since I have four players, I'm making it pick from 1 to 4. So then I want to add player to leaderboard. So instead of 1, you want picked integer. And also under this you want to set the leaderboard item text. And then set it at column 1, and then row picked integer. You want to set that to be the player name. So you go under function, and then you go name of player. And instead of triggering player, you want the picked integer. Okay. Now what I like to do is make another action, and it's going to be a leaderboard, and you want to set the leaderboard item text color. You want to set it to the same column, and then row picked integer again. And you want to set it to function color of player, so you have to convert player color to color. So instead of triggering player, you want picked integer. Okay, so now the player name will be there, and it will be the color of the player. So now, under the set variable action, you want to make a new action, and you want to set the headers. So I want to set leaderboard item text again. At column 1, instead of row 1, you want row header, which is under present. And I'm going to set that to player name. You can make it whatever you want, but this is what I'm making it. Now, I'm going to copy-paste that, and this time, instead of column 1, it's going to be column 2. And then this time I'm gonna make the name kills. Okay, so now under the picked integer action, you want to set text again, so I just copy pasted it. So you want column 2, row, you still want picked integer, and you want to set it to 0, and I copied the wrong one, so I'll copy this again. So you want column 2, row picked integer, and you want to set it to 0, so that they have 0 kills at the beginning of the game. Okay. So now what I also like to do is make an if statement to see if the player is in the game. So, if the status of player, status of player picked integer, and if that equals present, so you want it to be not equal, which is the one with the exclamation point. So if the picked integer player is not playing, then I want to set the text to in the I want to set the color to gray, so I'm going to pick a grayish color. And I want to make the name, instead of the name of player, just go to the value and type in not playing, so that if the player is not playing, it will just say they are not there. And this will also do this for any computer players. It will say not playing if you pick that player. And also to help this, you can copy and paste this condition. And you can say controller if the controller of player picked integer does not equal user, then you can also do this. And then you also, under this, you want an or, so that it's either or, so it will work a lot better. Okay, so now that you have your leaderboard, you have to show it. So under the picked integer, you want to show the leaderboard. So I'm just going to show all leaderboards, since I only have one, it doesn't really matter. But if you have multiple leaderboards, you'll have to specifically only show the one you want. But since I only have one, it doesn't really matter. So now what you have to do is make it so it keeps track of your kills. So I'm going to make a new variable and just name it kill count, and it will be an integer with an array of how many players you have. So for me it's 4. Then I'm going to make a new trigger and name it something like kill counts or whatever you want. So under the event, you want unit dies, and then after that you want to set variable and set the kill count and click the 0 and do killing player instead of 0, and you want to then do arithmetic for the next part. And then the variable that you just made, Again, replace the 0 with killing player. And then plus 1. So now every time a unit dies, the player who killed that unit will get 1 added on to that variable that we just made. And then after that, we want to set the leaderboard item text. So instead of the last created leaderboard, like the other ones, you want the variable that you made, which is just named leaderboard for me. And you want column 2, row, killing player. And you want to set that to a function and convert integer to text, because the variable is an integer, and you have to convert it. So then you go to your variable, and you choose that, and again replace the 0 with killing player. And there you go. So now it should update the text whenever a unit gets a kill. So now you go back to your leaderboard, make sure that everything is the way you want it, and then you can test it. So yeah, this is what I want. I also made them allies. And yeah, this is pretty much it. Now I'll test it. Thank you for watching.